Which of the following can never be a common factor of 287 plus x and 378 plus x, where x can be any natural number? And so which of the following can never be a common factor of? Lovely. And so take 287 plus x, 378 plus x. Remember, the question is not saying what, which of these four can be x. I'm saying that x can take any natural number. And then which of the following can never be a common factor of both of these? Very tricky question. Right? So I'm going to start by saying I'm going to put some value of x. I'm just going to get some from flow going. Right? So 287 plus 3. So this becomes 290. 378 plus 3 just becomes 381. Lovely. I don't know what is common between these two, but these two could be the values of 287 plus x, 378 plus x. We could add x to be 100, it will be 387, this will be 478. We could have x to be 1, this will be 288, this could be 379. Right? Any of these values, a million others are possible. Right? He's saying that x can be any natural number, which of the following can never be a common factor of? Whatever be the value of x, both of these cannot be a multiple of 26, or both of these cannot be a multiple of 13, both of these cannot be a multiple of 91, both cannot be a multiple of 7. And so I'm going to think about it. I'm going to now see, can I create two numbers, 287 plus x, 378 plus x, such that both are multiples of some number? I'm going to pick the smallest number, 7. And so 287 plus x, 378 plus x. X can be any natural number. So I'm going to divide 287 by 7. Yep, this is a multiple of 7. So I can add any multiple of 7. This will work. Let's say we add 7. So this becomes 294. And this becomes 385. Right? If 385 were also a multiple of 7, was 5 times 35, yep, this works. So if you add 7, both of these numbers happen to be multiples of 7. And so 7 works straight away. That means 7 is not a random choice. 7 could be a common factor between these two. And let's see next, 13, could it be a common factor between these two? So I have to divide 287 by 13. It goes 2 times 26, 27, good, 26. So the remainder is 1. So if we add 12, it'll become a multiple of 13. So 299 is a multiple of 13. I add another 12 there, 390. Oh yeah, this is a multiple of 13. This is also a multiple of 13. 13 also seems to work. So I can have a scenario where both are multiples of 13. Maybe every number is possible. Something we add, it'll happen to be for both. Maybe it is possible, maybe it is not. So it looks like we managed to find a number such that it was a multiple of, both were multiples of 7, both were multiples of 13. So what are we doing here? So if you see the pattern, 294, 385, 299, 390. There is a very involved, beautiful, delightful question. But even before we jump in to solving the more detailed one, you can guess the answer very quickly. How so? Think about this. Both of these numbers, this is odd, this is even. And so you have an odd number and an even number. To both, you're adding the same thing, adding x, and x is a natural number. So if x is odd, this will become even, that will become odd. If x were even, this will be odd, that will be even. So one of the two numbers is odd, the other is even. That much is very clear. Now look at the choices. One number is odd, the other number is even. Both of them cannot be a multiple of 26. Done. And so straight away, juicily, you can jump at that. Why have I done all this? Because that's probably the approach you'll have to take. You'll have to say, okay, can I find x such that both are multiples of 7? Can I find x such that both are multiples of 13? Can I find x such that both are multiples of 26? And then go step by step and then try to eliminate, trying to find a pattern. And the moment you do that, you realize that one of the numbers is odd, the other is even. Always. You have an odd number that can never be a multiple of 26. Both numbers cannot at the same time be a multiple of 26. You can have x such that this is a multiple of 26 or this is a multiple of 26. You cannot have a scenario where both are multiples of 26. Right? Beautiful. Now, is there a more textbook method of doing it, more standard method of doing it when you're trying different, something not just like this, but in some other context, fine? I'm going to introduce a very simple idea. If you have two numbers, P and Q, say 287 plus X and 2378 plus X, I'm calling it P and Q. Which of the following can never be a common factor? Right? I'm not going to talk about never be a common factor. Suppose, let's say, both of these, for them, a common factor. There exists a common factor. Let's say the common factor is phi. So phi divides P, phi divides Q. P divided by phi gives no remainder. Q divided by phi gives no remainder. Lovely. What does that mean? P is a multiple of phi, Q is a multiple of phi. I'm deliberately saying this in different ways. Phi is a factor of P, P is a multiple of phi. Phi is a factor of Q, Q is a multiple of phi. P is a multiple of phi, Q is a multiple of phi. Clearly, P plus Q will also be a multiple of phi. P minus Q will also be a multiple of phi. That idea that you have two numbers that are multiples of phi, you add them, the sum will also be a multiple of phi. You subtract one from the other, the difference will also be a multiple of phi, is very useful, very powerful. Let's come to our question. So if you have a number F factor that divides 287 plus X and divides 378 plus X, if F is a factor of this and of this, that means it will automatically be a factor of this plus this. Add these two numbers and then you'll get 2x. That's not fun. It'll automatically be a factor of this minus this. I'm going to subtract 287 plus x from 378 plus x. This is a larger number. The x part will disappear. It'll be a factor of 378 minus 287. 8 minus 7 is 1. 78 minus 8 is 91. If there is a number f that divides this and this, then it will definitely divide 91. Conversely, if a number is not a factor of 91, then it cannot be a factor of this and this. Or if any number is there which is not a factor of 91, then it cannot be. It is the number that we are looking for, which is this. Suppose you had been given choices 13, 91, 7, and 11. Then it's a trickier question. We cannot do with our odd and even. Just looking at the numbers and saying odd number, even number, 26 cannot multiply, 26 cannot be a factor, you can't jump in. You'll have to have a mechanism to get there. That mechanism is based on just one idea. If P is a multiple of phi, Q is a multiple of phi, then P plus Q is a multiple of phi, P minus Q is a multiple of phi. So 287 plus X and 378 plus X, both of them are multiples of this factor F. Then 91 will also be a multiple of this factor F, or R number F has to be a factor of 91. If it is not a factor of 91, then it cannot satisfy this condition, which means we're looking for choices that are factors of 91 and eliminating them. 91 is 13 into 7, so all three are out. Remaining 26 is the right answer. We had a juicier, easier, simpler method to get to 26, but even if you did not have that, then you have to do this way, which is why this is tough. This is not easy. If you tried many things, put X as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20, and got to different points, that is useful. These questions are non-routine. Therefore, I want you guys definitely to try several things. It is very easy to look at this question and see this answer and then understand the solution and nod away. You'll really take value from it if you have tried for 10, 12 minutes, not gone anywhere, and then you see the solution. But that process of 10, 12 minutes gets you ready to take in the solution and apply this in a different context next time around. So don't just watch the solution, try before you hit the solution.